Hello to my new subscribers and group members. I'm Kathy Flynn, and this is Thriving with Autism. Today, I'm going to give you a very simple tip at home to build the foundation for your child to request. If you have a nonverbal or partially verbal child at home who is not requesting his or her favorite things, then listen up. This video will be enlightening for you. One of the biggest reasons children with autism do not learn to request items at home is because they are given open access to all of their favorite things. The only items that are put away are the foods or snacks, because these items go into pantries, cabinets, or refrigerators. I hear it all the time. My child brings me to the kitchen when he wants to eat. My daughter gestures to the cabinets, but then I need to try to figure out which snack she wants. We put food away, right? We don't want food out all over the place. It's already packaged in bags, boxes, and containers, and then we store it properly behind closed doors. This is why your child has to come to you to try to figure out how to get that favorite snack or food. Even if your child has some access to the pantry and has learned to open the door, you probably need to help him or her open the packaging. Most children with autism have a very difficult time with opening boxes and packages because they are limited or underdeveloped in fine motor skills. I'm laughing to myself because I say it all the time in my classroom, pinch and pull, to teach them how to open snack packaging. I get their fingers ready in the correct place and guide the pinch and pull until they can do it by themselves. Otherwise, they are always giving us snacks or food to open for them. However, the point of this video is to teach you to take this brilliance and apply it to the other items in the house. The foods are away. How about the toys? Is your child's favorite fire truck, stuffed animal, or blocks within reach and able to be accessed all the time? Or if your child does not play with toys, but instead loves a piece of string or putty, or the iPad, are these items out and ready to be picked up by your child whenever he or she feels like it? Your child will never learn to request these items if he or she always has access to them. I'm going to tell you a story that I was told when I was in my first language development class in college. A child who was the youngest of five in a big family was not talking. If I recall, I think he was about 2 or 3 years old. He had access to his favorite toys, and whatever he did not have access to, he figured out how to get his siblings or parents to get for him. Because he was the baby and didn't talk, they helped him as much as possible. However, when he finally went for a speech evaluation, it turned out that he could speak. He had language. He just never used his language because he was never forced to. Everyone always did things for him, and he never needed to talk to tell them what he wanted. This story stuck with me, as I'm hoping it will stick with you, because it is so eye-opening. It is so critical to set up your environment at home for success. If you give your child open access to everything, he or she will not need to request. We need to force the situation. We need to make it challenging so that there is a motivation to request. We need to put the toys away. Referring back to the food example from before, your foods are away and in packages and boxes that are difficult to open. Put the toys away on shelves or in other plastic bags, bins, or boxes that are hard to open. I say clear plastic because you want your child to be able to see where his or her favorite items are so that he or she does not become frustrated or upset that these items have disappeared. But you want to make it difficult to get these items. As I said in my reinforcement video, you want to be the keeper of these favorite things. You want to set it up so that your child needs you to give him or her access to these favorites. You will be needed to open the bin or container just like when you open a food package. If your child is self-directed and plays by himself or herself and runs from one activity to the next within minutes, and you have granted open access to everything, then you'll never get your child to want to approach you or need you until it's time for the bathroom, time to eat, time to get dressed, or go somewhere. In addition, you will have not created the motivation to request. In my classroom, we keep everything sealed and in bins, and we work on requesting all day, in addition to many other skills. Now, if your child can say words and is able to vocally imitate, then you can say the word to have him or her repeat to get access to the favorite. Like this, say car. Great job saying car, nice requesting, here you go. If your child is nonverbal, you can teach him or her to point to what he or she wants. Your child is probably indicating that he or she wants something by reaching for it or putting your hand on it. Shape his or her hand to point. This is the first step. Of course, this requesting for nonverbal children can become way more advanced with sign language or pictures. These strategies will be explained step by step in an upcoming digital course to be released in November. So stay tuned for details on that. Until then, work on these simple strategies explained here and understand how important it is to set up the environment appropriately to build communication. Put everything away. If you need more tips on getting your child to sit with you and want to approach you, click on the link in the description to get my free guide, the number one way to connect with your nonverbal child. Until next time, I'm Kathy Flynn, and this is Thriving with Autism.